to the level of extraordinary sportsmanship. Such was the case in a high school soccer game that took place just a few miles from here. It featured an admirable display of integrity, made all the more impressive when you consider what was at stake.
Same progression, quickly, get it going, everybody's moving.
At the St. Louis Priory School, in addition to English and math, there are lessons about character.
Everybody switch roles, one more time, quickly.
Head soccer coach John Mormon, whose first couple of teams only won a handful of games.
A little more communication.
Also had to teach patience.
Yeah, we had a lot of years like that where, you know, it was just victories were hard to come by.
Not anymore. After 20 years, Mormon's teams now always rank among the top of the state, and they're coming off a perfect 27-0 state championship season.
We had our eyes on the prize, and we weren't gonna hold back.
They were good. I don't think I've seen a high school team, at least at our class, be that dominant, be that consistent, game in and game out.
When you win a championship,
good start, Mike. Good start.
Every victory is memorable, but one in particular was remarkable. In the district playoffs, Priory faced off against Westminster Christian Academy. Priory and Westminster had played twice during the regular season, with Priory winning handily both times. But in that first district playoff game, Westminster was giving them all they could handle.
It was very rainy and windy, and it was very harsh conditions. Kind of a swirling wind day, and kind of a day where, you know, the finesse game that Priory has was not going to work.
The year before, Priory was the top-ranked team in the state until they were upset in the district playoffs. So their fans started to get nervous when the game against Westminster remained scoreless through the first 30 minutes. Then, finally, the ball bounced Priory's way. A rebound off the crossbar, and it was 1-0 Rebels.
I think their players kind of hesitated for a moment. He stuck it in the goal. And you felt that relief.
I just remember jumping up, arms in the air, thinking, finally.
But something was amiss. The Westminster players complained to the officials that the ball not only hit the soccer crossbar, but the football crossbar as well, making it out of play.
Five of them stopped in the middle of the play. They didn't play on. They thought it was going to get called up for out of bounds as hit the post.
The referees didn't see it that way. They counted the goal and were about to restart the game with Priory in front when Coach John Mormon stepped off the sidelines and onto the field.
And I called the ref that was closest to me over to the side and just told him it wasn't a goal.
For a moment, it seemed no one could move. The coach of the team that scored the goal convinced the officials it should be disallowed.
I was shocked. I mean, no coaches ever, take back a goal themselves.
And he was risking a perfect season, you know, a chance for a state title for his team.
My first reaction is that's totally classy. I said, that takes a lot of courage.
And I wanted to win the state championship. Everybody on our team did. You know, we were thinking about it before the season even started. But we didn't want to get through on that.
One of the Priory parents, Don Anselm, was taping the game. And when he slowed down the video, he thought it did hit the football crossbar. And in his mind, the soccer field became a classroom that day.
Well, what better way to not only teach them English and soccer, but also teach them honor.
Priory did eventually score again and hung on to win 1-0 on the way to that perfect season. In time, the players may not remember the Westminster game, but it will stay with them just the same.
We know that that's a way to go through life, but we have to play it fair. We have to do what we know is right, no matter what.
One coach respecting the game and his opponent and showing there's never a wrong time to do the right thing.
Sportsmanship can be contagious, too.
So here he is leading the Rebels on stage. Let's salute John Mormon.